So President Trump spent much as yesterday, as Willie mentioned, defending his decision to withdraw troops from northern Syria, even as key Republicans and allies urge him against leaving America's Kurdish allies open to an assault from Turkey. Multiple current and former U.S. officials tell NBC News that the announcement blindsided not just America's Kurdish partners in the fight against ISIS, but also senior officials at the Pentagon, the State Department, and the White House, as well as lawmakers on Capitol Hill, and also U.S. allies in Europe and the Middle East. This is pretty full-throated all around the world. The one person that the president did consult with before making that decision, Turkish President Erdogan.
Why are you siding with an authoritarian leader and not our Kurdish allies?
Well, I'm not siding with anybody. We've been in Syria for many years. You know, Syria was supposed to be a short-term hit, just a very short-term hit, and we were supposed to be in and out. I don't want anything bad to happen to our people. And I told that to President Erdogan. I said, don't hurt any of our people get hurt. Big trouble.
Those remarks followed the president's tweet threatening to, quote, totally destroy and obliterate Turkey's economy. That's quite a threat.
Yeah.
If Turkey, quote, does anything that I and my great and unmatched wisdom, this is the president talking, consider to be off limits. But many Republicans.
I'm sorry, my great and unmatched wisdom. He has the great and unmatched wisdom of Chief Wiggum on The Simpsons.
I'm just worried about the people who still stand up for him do not see that we've got a president who works
well,
for
the
Putin.
Thing is, Mika, many Republicans don't see great and unmatched wisdom in the Syria decision. They see more Krusty the Clown or Chief Wiggum. And actually, they are voicing their complaints.
Yes.
Let's roll the tape. Well, I can't read the script if you don't roll the script.
Well,
you know,
so
that's
decision,
a problem. You see, there you go. They were voicing their opposition,
Majority,
Mika. They're yelling to me, read the script.
Okay, I got it.
But why don't you read the script?
I got it. Majority Leader Mitch McConnell put out a statement saying, in part, a precipitous withdrawal of U.S. forces from Syria would only benefit Russia, Iran, and the Assad regime, and it would increase the risk that ISIS and other terrorist groups regroup. That's Mitch McConnell. Senator Lindsey Graham, one of the president's strongest defenders, slammed the move in a series of tweets yesterday. This is Lindsey Graham. He warned that the decision ensures an ISIS comeback. It forces Kurds to align with Assad and Iran. It destroys Turkey's relationship with Congress and said abandoning the Kurds would be a stain on America's honor.
ISIS is not defeated, my friend. The biggest lie being told by the administration that ISIS is defeated. The caliphate's destroyed, but there are thousands of fighters over there, and no, the caliphate would not have been destroyed without the Kurds. This impulsive decision by the president has undone all the gains we've made, thrown the region into further chaos. Iran is licking their chops, and if I'm an ISIS fighter, I've got a second lease on life. This, to me, is just unnerving to its core.
Well,
wow.
And here's the thing to follow up on that. Marco Rubio, I mean, go ahead, Mika. Go through this list because I want to follow up on something that Lindsey said.
Because it appears the president works for someone else. Rubio said reports of a U.S. retreat are true. The Trump administration has made a grave mistake. Former Governor Mike Huckabee called it a huge mistake to abandon Kurds. Trump's former U.N. ambassador, Nikki Haley, said leaving the Kurds to die is a big mistake. And Senator Ben Sasse said this bad decision will likely result in the slaughter of allies. So literally everybody knows that people will die, but yet the president continues. We also want to show you the reaction from longtime televangelist and Trump ally, Pat Robertson. Here's what he had to say.
The president who allowed Khashoggi to be cut in pieces without any repercussions whatsoever is now allowing the Christians and the Kurds to be massacred by the Turks. And I believe, and I want to say this with great solemnity, the president of the United States is in danger of losing the mandate of heaven if he permits this to happen.
Richard Haass, of course, the condemnation is almost universal. I want to follow up on something Lindsey Graham said. He said, if I'm an ISIS fighter, I have a second lease on life. Well, Lindsey, though he often, when defending the president, just makes things up, in this case, he has a Pentagon study, an IG report to actually back him up. The Pentagon several weeks ago said that there was a danger because of United States neglect. There was a danger of ISIS reforming and once again causing this sort of chaos that they caused not only across the Middle East, but in America and across the world. And this move yesterday could not, Donald Trump could not have done more of a favor for ISIS, Iran, Russia, Turkey, all of these people who consider themselves to be our adversaries than he did. Is there any explanation that you can come up with?
Well, the only explanation is the one the president keeps giving, that he was, quote unquote, elected to bring American troops home from the Middle East, and he's doing that, the consequences be damned. There's zero chance the Kurds, if they're fighting for their lives against Turkey, are going to have the capacity to continue to guard the thousands of ISIS fighters so that ISIS would be able to reconstitute itself. But, Joe, this is part of a much larger piece, the desire to get the United States, U.S. forces out of Afghanistan. And again, consequences be damned, if given what the Taliban could do. And so the consequences of this are not simply good for Iran, good for Russia, good for Syria, and all that. What this does is it sends the message again worldwide. It reinforces the message that the United States is no longer reliable. We are no longer predictable. We can no longer be counted on. So if you are an ally of the United States, this sends the message, essentially, you are on your own. No matter what the alliance commitments are or the treaty commitments, you are increasingly on your own, no matter what sort of documents or papers or previous commitments have been there. This president essentially has started from a blank slate and does not honor his inheritance.
Let's bring in Eamon Maloudina. Go ahead, Joe.
No, I was just going to say, Willie, it's even worse than that. I mean, if you have fought along with the United States, if you have been the one true ally of the United States through over the past 10 years of some pretty rough sledding. It was always the Kurds in Iraq. We could depend on the Kurds in Syria that stayed with us, that were the fiercest fighters, that always helped us move forward and get through these crises. They were our steadfast ally. The message, Richard is right, is sent across the globe. I have got to ask you really quickly also before you bring in Eamon. We have a new poll out, a Washington Post poll came out, and it's curious that the president would make this decision. I'm sure he was trying to just change the subject, or maybe, as we know with his phone calls from foreign leaders, maybe he got something out of it, because this certainly is not in America's best interest or our allies' best interest. It's in ISIS's best interest. But you saw all those Republicans attacking the president. I'm wondering why he would do this when the support for impeachment just grows by the day. There's a Washington Post poll out this morning, Willie. Get this. We'll get the numbers up in a minute. 58% of Americans support the impeachment proceedings against Donald Trump.
58.
Only 38% now oppose it by a 20-point spread. 58-38, according to this latest Washington Post poll, 58% of Americans want this man to go through an impeachment inquiry.
And that's after what the American public watched all week yesterday. We saw all week last week the president reeling in the question of impeachment. You saw Rob Portman of Ohio, a Republican senator, showing some cracks in his support yesterday, talking to a local newspaper in Ohio, the Columbus Dispatch, saying the president's conduct was inappropriate and unacceptable. So clearly this is on the president's mind. And we have to sprinkle in there, Joe, the president of the United States, I know you guys talked about this yesterday, has two hotels in Istanbul in Turkey. The question of business hangs over everything this president does.
Just, Willie, just one more number for you and then bring in Eamon. What's that number?
49% of Americans, 49% support impeachment and removal from office. It's statistically, I mean, within the margin of error, half of Americans support Donald Trump's removal from office. And, you know, I think part of it is you can read through the Mueller report. So many Republicans on the Hill didn't read through it. A lot of Americans didn't read through it. There's a lot there to digest. But if you read it, it's obvious this president is not acting in America's best interest. But here, Willie, you touch on something very important. He calls Ukraine, and of course, this is a country recently invaded by Russia. He's holding up $391 million in defense money. Why? For his campaign's benefit. So he extorts the leader of a Democratic ally. Americans can understand that, misusing the office for his political gain. He makes a call to China, somebody that he has said is our enemy. But he calls China, and he's talking, and what does he do? He not only says it on TV, he says it in a phone call a couple of months back, reportedly, and he says, help my campaign out. I need you to investigate the guy who's ahead of me by 9 points in a poll. Americans can understand that. In a few minutes, we're going to show this guy's connections with Turkey, his financial connections with Turkey. Americans understand that. Why is it that he's nice to countries where his son says gives him the most money, Russia? Why is it that he bends over backwards to help the Saudis out when, what did Donald Trump say in the campaign? They like my toys. They've given me $150 million. Why is it that the Philippines, everybody else is turning on the Philippines because they have a savage leader there who doesn't respect any human rights or norms? Why? He's got hotel property there. And guess what, Willie? As you said, the same thing with Turkey. Why is it that every time he gets on the phone call with Erdogan, he gets off and he makes decisions that Americans understand are not in our best interest? Whether you're on Fox News, Fox and Friends, Brian Kilmeade, or whether you're on the 700 Club, Pat Robertson, or whether you're a guy that goes golfing with Donald Trump and you've completely forsaken everything that you believed in with John McCain regarding constitutional norms, you're Lindsey Graham. All of these people understand none of this is in America's best interest. It all has to do with what we always say, the bottom line. It always comes back to the bottom line for Donald Trump. And now, I think that's why 49% of Americans want him removed from office. 58% of Americans support this impeachment inquiry.
Yeah, and remember, this is the very reason General Mattis left the administration over this question of Syria and getting out of Syria. We don't have General Mattis next to the president because of that. Why does the president give Erdogan a pass time and again? Remember, it was just a couple of years ago, Ayman Mohyeldin, when Erdogan's security guards on American soil in Washington beat up peaceful protesters as Erdogan watched. Charges were dropped. Time and again, this president gives a pass to Erdogan. But let's talk about what's happening on the ground. This surprise, not just to the SDF, but to allies around the world, to the Pentagon, to the State Department, the surprise decision. Imagine you're the commander in the field leading the SDF. You get a call, according to Carol Lee's reporting at NBC News, at 3 a.m. yesterday morning, basically to stand down, and that American troops are leaving your side, a complete surprise to that commander.
Yeah, and the first thing that you're probably thinking of is that all your troops and all the people that you've had on the front lines are now exposed in some way, shape, or form. They're either going to be exposed from the Turkish side, that the Turks could possibly begin shelling certain positions inside Syria. They could even advance. And there's all kinds of calculations that Turks have to go through before they take on that risk. But essentially, the green light has been given for them to at least begin some kind of remote airstrikes, as we've seen in the past. But also what it does is it upends the kind of quiet norm that had been existing, because the Syrian government and their Russian backers have made clear that they wouldn't tolerate any invasion or any military operation by Turkey in Syrian sovereign territory. So the Syrian government now is making a calculation. They're going to try to win over the Kurds. They're going to try to offer them some kind of concession to bring them back into the fold, to keep the integrity of that country in place. And so you could see yourself once again opening another front between Turkey and Syria. You talked about the fact that President Erdogan has snubbed President Trump on many times, including most recently when the American military told Turkey, do not buy those Russian surface-to-air missiles. That was a very big decision. And what did Turkey do? They totally snubbed the Americans by saying, no, we will continue to buy these Russian surface-to-air missiles, despite the fact that NATO and America said no. And what does President Trump do? A couple weeks after that decision, he turns around and grants Turkey something they've been pushing for years, a green light to attack Kurds inside Syria.
So thanks for checking out MSNBC on YouTube, and make sure you subscribe to stay up to date on the day's biggest stories. And you can click on any of the videos around us to watch more from Morning Joe and MSNBC. Thanks so much for watching.